upside down, it got me going crazy. Psychedelics got me going crazy.
Bro, Travis was not slumping on his VIP area, bro. His whole VIP is an experience. Like, wow. Okay. Bro, this nigga got massage, face painting, glam squad. Like, he wasn't playing with his VIPs. The roadie.
Hola chicas, back again. So I'm gonna do a recap of how all this stuff went down really quickly and tell you all about the Kali lip kit that was exclusive to this event. First and foremost, we didn't buy our tickets until this morning at 10:30, and the fest started at 12. And yes, I lost a nail. One, we got scammed twice. My friend got scammed trying to get our tickets, and they were like, basically how we knew it was a scam, because they were like, oh, do you have PayPal? They're like, no, we have Venmo or Cash App. PayPal, you can actually get your money back with them. The other ones, you can't. So that was one issue. I don't want to talk about it. But they ended up selling tickets through Frontgate, and I was trying to get the tickets from there before, but I was waiting on my friend Raven to, you know, get them for cheaper, because they were $182 per person on the website. And then after we got scammed twice, I was just like, forget it, I'm gonna get it from this website. And at first when I went back, it was like sold out, wouldn't let me do it. So the second time I went back, it let me do it. So I was like, thank God. So that was about 11. We didn't get there actually until 3 o'clock sharp, because we didn't really care about the other performers, and we knew that Travis wasn't performing until late. So we were perfectly fine with, you know, getting there at 3, because we at least got to see Sheck West, and we also got to see, who else did we see? Lil Wayne, a little bit of Lil Wayne, and I want to say that was about it. And then Travis, we waited in line for merchandise for 1 hour and 30 minutes. Some people have been waiting for 5 hours. Well, let me start from the entrance. The whole event itself, my arm is really killing me, y'all, was super live. Like, I loved it. It was a true experience. He really went all out on that. It was great. I'll tell you that much. He had rides, food. They had Popeyes, Frenchies, Peli Peli, which is like a South African restaurant. Fast food or whatever, just all these different options. We didn't even know about the other half of the carnival until later. Like, he had the dungeon drop, the little swings that swing around really fast, the dome that had the LEDs above your head, and actually had carpet on the floor where you can lay down and look up at it. And people were in there literally like knocked out, like sleep, because they were just trying to like chill and get off their feet. He had the carousel ride, of course, and then a Ferris wheel that we didn't get a chance to get on. But everything else was really fun. They had like balloons and little games. It was so well put together. It was a true carnival. I say it was like the Houston version of Coachella. It was lit. There was a lot of people who flew in just to come see it. Also, another thing was the VIP. Now that I know what the VIP looks like, I would have definitely paid money for that VIP. Y'all, they had so much stuff, like the foot massage, the glam squat, a barbershop. You could have got your hair cut. They had hammocks. They even had heating things out there because it was cold. So you could, you know, stay warm if you wanted to. They had their own bar area, their own little food section. They had their own section to watch the show. It was a lot further back, but hey, whatever. I think they also had a section off on the side too, but to me it was still a little bit far from the stage. He also had two separate stages. So if you look at the lineup, it'll say like Thrills, and then the other one was something else. I couldn't remember. So it was actually the performers who were performing on Thrills. You would have to run over there to go watch it. And then Travis Scott performed on the bigger stage. Post Malone was pretty good too, I would have to say. We kind of heard his music. The cons, really quickly, so those were basically the pros, was the overall atmosphere. He truly sold you an experience. I definitely do think it was worth the money. He had great performers, number three. I feel like it was a great event all the way around, and you really got your money's worth. The part that I really hated was it wasn't enough people working the event. It was only one exit, one in, one way out, but towards the end they let us go through the VIP area, which is how we saw what it really looked like. I also didn't like the fact that he dropped the lineup at the very last minute. He dropped it the day before, and then you didn't really know what you were getting with the different sections. And that really pissed me off, because some of them said level 4, level 5. And I'm like, what does that mean? Like, you had no clue what that meant, and then you had no clue what came with the VIP. But it was so worth it. They had their own game area. It was just really lax. And I think that was worth, I guess, the $300 or $600, however much it was. But it was definitely worth that, because you go to a lot of concerts and you don't get half of that. But then again, this was the festival, so if you just went to the concert, I know he probably didn't have all of that. But what else? Yeah, it wasn't enough people working. Like, to stand in a line for 5 hours just to get merchandise, that's ridiculous. It was literally only like 5 people working up there. And keep in mind, it was over 40,000 people at this event. It was 67,000 that brought tickets, but I guess 50,000 showed up or something like that. And it was 40,000 people near the stage. It was so many people passing out. like literally passing the fuck out right in front of us. And all the mosh pits, that was just the craziest thing ever. I did not like that. It was so crazy. Like it was better to stand in the back than opposed to being in the front. But I'm gonna show you all the Kylie lip kit. So this is the lip kit right here. I really liked her packaging on it. I honestly actually already have, sorry y'all, these colors. So they weren't, I guess, truly different. I don't know, maybe they were. Let me try to get in the light so y'all can see. But it's this really fiery, bright red color that I would never wear. I actually think I already have Savage. This looks like something I really already have. And then this one right here actually might sell these. So if you all want them, let me know before I put them on eBay. I am going to keep the packaging though, because the packaging was really the only thing that I wanted. I honestly didn't care for these colors. Somebody posted it before we even went to the event. And let me show you all my other merch. Where did I put it? Oh, I put it in my closet. Sorry for the mess, y'all. But they ran out of small, so the only thing that they had was a large. But I really like this one. This cost $65, and the lip kit cost $35. And then on the side, it has all of his tour dates. And then the front, this is what the front says. Wish you were there. Or wish you were here. Sorry. So, yeah, this was pretty lit. Sorry, y'all, my phone cut off. But what I was going to say is I overall had a great time. It was definitely worth the experience and the headache. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Okay, go ahead and add a girl. Let me know what's up. Let me know if you have any questions or whatnot. But I'm tired as hell, so I'm going to go to sleep. And I will talk to you all another time. The sky keep on falling. The drug keep on calling. The sky keep on falling.